Hey, so today I wanted to talk about why diesel engines tend to consume less fuel compared to gasoline engines. It's a question a lot of people ask, and honestly, it's a pretty interesting topic because it dives deep into how engines work, chemistry, and physics all mixed together. So let's take it step by step and break it down in a way that's easy to understand, even if you're not an engineer or anything. First off, both diesel and gasoline engines work on what we call the four-stroke cycle. You know, the classic intake, compression, power, and exhaust strokes that make an internal combustion engine run. So, in that sense, they're pretty similar. They both suck air in, compress it, burn fuel, and push the piston down to create power. But the way they actually ignite the fuel and manage the air-fuel mixture is quite different, and this difference is at the heart of why diesel engines are generally more fuel efficient. All right, let's start with gasoline engines. In gasoline engines, the air and fuel are mixed together before they enter the combustion chamber. This means you get a nice, even air-fuel mixture, kind of like a smoothie, before the combustion starts. Then, a spark plug creates a tiny spark at just the right moment to ignite this mixture, causing a controlled explosion that pushes the piston down and generates power. The spark plug's role is crucial here, because without that spark, the mixture wouldn't ignite properly. Now, diesel engines are a bit different. They don't have spark plugs. Well, most of them don't. Instead, they rely on something called compression ignition. Here's how it works. During the intake stroke, the engine sucks in only air, no fuel mixed in yet. Then, during the compression stroke, this air is compressed so much that its temperature rises dramatically, sometimes over 500 degrees Celsius. When the piston reaches the top of the cylinder, fuel is injected directly into this super hot compressed air. Because the air is so hot, the fuel ignites immediately without needing a spark. This is why diesel engines can run without spark plugs.
This difference in ignition method is huge because it means diesel engines operate under much higher compression ratios compared to gasoline engines. Compression ratio is basically the ratio between the maximum and minimum volume in the cylinder. So, how much the air is squeezed before ignition? Diesel engines often have compression ratios ranging from 16 to 1 up to even 20 to 1 in some modern designs, whereas gasoline engines usually run between 8 to 1 and 12 to 1. Higher compression ratios lead to better thermal efficiency, meaning the engine can extract more energy from each drop of fuel. All right, so why does this mean diesel engines use less fuel? Well, because of the way combustion happens in a diesel engine, it can operate with much leaner air-fuel mixtures. In other words, there's more air compared to fuel in the cylinder. This lean burn helps the engine run more efficiently and produce less waste heat. On the other hand, gasoline engines need a near-perfect air-fuel mix to avoid misfires or knocking, typically around 14.7 parts air to 1 part fuel by weight, known as the stoichiometric ratio. Diesel engines, however, can run with ratios as high as 40 to 1 or even leaner in some cases. Now, let's talk about the throttle valve, which is another big difference. In gasoline engines, when you press the accelerator pedal, you're actually opening a throttle valve that controls how much air gets into the engine. The more air, the more fuel the engine injects to maintain the right mixture, and the more power you get. This throttle valve is a kind of gatekeeper, and it's constantly adjusting to how much you want to accelerate. Diesel engines usually don't have a throttle valve controlling the air intake, at least not in the same way. Instead, they let in as much air as possible at all times. The engine controls power output by adjusting how much fuel is injected into the cylinders. So, pressing the accelerator pedal simply increases the amount of fuel sprayed into the hot compressed air, which changes how powerful each combustion event is. This means the engine is always breathing freely, and power is controlled by fuel flow. This design reduces pumping losses, which is basically the energy the engine spends to pull air through the throttle, losses which can be significant in gasoline engines, especially at low loads.
Another point to consider is the energy density of the fuels themselves. Diesel fuel contains more energy per liter compared to gasoline. This means that when burning diesel, the engine gets more energy out of the same volume of fuel. This contributes to the improved fuel economy of diesel engines. Also, diesel fuel has a different chemical composition. It's heavier, oilier, and has higher cetane number, which essentially means it ignites more easily under compression. Gasoline has a higher octane number, which is related to its resistance to knocking or premature ignition, suitable for spark ignition engines. Now, there are some downsides to diesel engines too. They tend to be heavier because the engine block and components need to withstand higher compression pressures. Also, diesel engines can produce more nitrogen oxides, NOx, and particulate emissions,
which have led to stricter emission controls in recent years. But from a purely fuel efficiency standpoint, diesel engines generally come out ahead. Modern diesel engines have also incorporated advanced technologies like turbocharging, common rail, direct injection, and exhaust aftertreatment systems, which have greatly improved their performance, reduced emissions, and increased fuel efficiency. To sum up, diesel engines are more fuel efficient because they use compression ignition, operate at higher compression ratios, run leaner air-fuel mixtures, don't restrict airflow with a throttle valve, and burn a denser fuel with more energy content. All these factors add up to lower fuel consumption compared to gasoline engines. And that's why diesels typically use less fuel. It's a mix of chemistry, physics, and smart engineering.